Hi guys, thanks for stopping by my channel again. My name is Brandy, I'm the owner of Beauty Designs, and today we're going to make a three-tier cupcake stand, and I'm going to show you exactly how I did it. In this video, I am using what's left of my FX epoxy. I have more epoxy on the way from CC DIY, which is what I prefer to use. I just didn't order any on time to make this video, so I'll put a link for that below. And then I am using some mica powders and some acrylic paint. I'm mixing it with my epoxy. So as I was pouring my epoxy, I realized that I put the popsicle sticks in before I had my pigment in the cups. So remember not to do that, just so you don't have to waste popsicle sticks. It was just something I had tried to stay organized with, and I threw them in the cups not thinking about it. So you want to make sure that you don't do that, because if you put your popsicle sticks in your mica powders, you're going to have a mess. So the first mica powder that I'm going to be mixing up is from Dryer Days Studio, and it's called Forest. It is the perfect shade of green. It is by far one of my favorite colors. There's the lid to it, and I'll have a link down below so you guys know where to find that. Right now she's doing a Black Friday special, so if you guys want to get your hands on that, I highly suggest it. It's beautiful. And the next color from Dryer Days Studio, and it's called Forest. It is the perfect shade of green. It is by far one of my favorite colors. There's the lid to it, and I'll have a link down below so you guys know where to find that. Right now she's doing a Black Friday special, so if you guys want to get your hands on that, I highly suggest it. It's beautiful. So the next color is Jasmine, and that is from Glitter Chimp. That is where I get all of my glitters. They have one of the largest selections and amazing quality, so make sure to check out them if you're in the shop for glitters. They also have mica powders, and they recently started carrying the marabou paints, which I'm really excited about. So the third color is Charcoal from Glitter Chimp. It is a beautiful black, and it does have some shimmer to it. And then I use some gold acrylic paint in the very last cup, and I only use just a little bit. A little goes a long way. I didn't have any good gold mica powder, so I went with the acrylic paint. Which is completely possible. Just don't put too much in your epoxy, because then it will get tacky and stringy, and you really want your epoxy to be thin and workable for these molds. Thank you. So I decided to go ahead and try to get the epoxy all the way to the edges as much as I can. It just gives it a good base. Sometimes I can get pretty good effects with doing it this way, which I've noticed. So something I've noticed with these silicone molds is that bottom, the largest piece, has where the hardware goes, it is kind of recessed, so your screw will fit perfectly in there and not make your piece wobbly, which I absolutely love these. I also got them from Dryer Days. I love watching her videos, so if you ever get a chance, go check hers out. She's amazing. So I start by taking the black and going around the edges. It is important to keep in mind that you should be using a heat gun and not staying on your molds too long because it will ruin them if you have too much heat. But please do not torch your silicone molds. I have done this. I have learned my mistake. I ruined the mold completely. So just make sure that you are using a heat gun and not an open flame because it will singe them and it will ruin these beautiful molds. So after the white and the heat gun, I went in with the green, and oh my gosh, this green is just gorgeous. I decided to do the gold just in the center and see what kind of effects it gave me. But I can't get enough of that green. I want to use it in everything. So I'm just trying to go around and fill any empty spots with the epoxy. I think I added too much black because it kind of took over. You'll see that in the very end. So just be mindful that a little goes a long way with the darker colors. So less than that. Thank you. So I kind of decided I wanted to kind of move it around myself and give it a really, really cool effect. As you can see, I'm just using that popsicle stick to just move it around, and then it just kind of develops on its own. Get all of the epoxy in there that I want and just kind of move things around a little bit, hit it with the heat gun. I'm gonna let these rest and kind of do their own thing. They'll develop into the design that they're supposed to be, which it's really cool to see the different techniques and the different outcomes of it. So at the very end of the video, you will see what they turned into. And like I said, I think the black took over a little bit, but I still think that they are beautiful. I cannot wait to make more designs and to see what I can come up with. So if you have any questions, let me know. I'd be glad to answer them. Like I said, I'll link everything below. And you know, just be creative. If you guys want to try these, just try it out. It's actually really fun. It's really relaxing. And the worst part is you have to wait for everything to set up in the mold before you can make anything else. So definitely gotta have patience or order more molds. That's kind of what I'm facing. So you guys just have fun and stay safe, and I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. So after I get all of the epoxy in there that I want and just kind of move things around a little bit, hit it with the heat gun. I'm gonna let these rest and kind of do their own thing. They'll develop into the design that they're supposed to be, which it's really cool to see the different techniques and the different outcomes of it. Thank you guys for watching my video. Let me know what you think. If you have any questions or comments, let me know and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. You guys stay safe out there, and Happy holidays.